So, all right, we're continuing with the transformer copper core amplifier. And before going on, let me just give credit to the author of the book, Integrated Electronics, by Electronic Circuits, Discrete and Integrated, Donald L. Schilling and Charles Beloved. Page 232, those who want the original perspective from this transformer copper power amplifier could look at the book, Electronic Circuits, Discrete and Integrated, Donald L. Schilling. And I want to thank my good friend, Professor Scheinberg. Yeah, Professor Scheinberg, he gave the book so graciously to me. And yeah, my doing this class today. Okay, so let's continue. Where do we know the power calculations from electronic circuits? Transformer coupled amplifier, and let's just say that we also take a look at the inductor copper amplifier, which is in the book before the transform copper amplifier. All right, we maintain the diagram. That's the way of the power factor. Now, the power calculation presented is identical to or similar to some of the power calculations I've done in previous lectures. And this is same for the inductor coupled amplifier. So we are need some power calculation for the inductor coupled amplifier. So you only made reference to it. But we did this before we did the inductor coupled amplifier. So what you said now, I see. I collected Z equals to I C N sine omega t. We call that now 5.2 dash. And that now P C C equal now to VCC and CQ equal to V squared. Yeah, this is just coming from the, even the high school formula for power. Everybody knows that the power is P is equal to VI for the electrical thing, is equal to I squared R. Is equal to V squared upon R. V squared upon R. VI, yeah, it's the same power formula, but with a little more added to it now when we bring in the calculus, the integral sign and the integration. I think we will see that power in general, volume T is equal to from of V dt. Yes, that's the general power formula. 1 over P of T is equal to, depending if we're taking unilateral or bilateral integration sign, 1 over T, V of T, or I of T, dt. Same P and I. So P, CC here will be equal to VCC, ICQ, equal to V squared CC. Upon R upon L. No, the power transfer to the load, I always think of the supply power. writing fast, I make my C's as L and my L's as C. So you want to differentiate where is the C and what is the L. You know, sometimes it's not like I know. Or I see is very close sometimes. So you have to see the relevant application of these subscripts. So we have another supply power. Was this 5.2 volts now? And the power transfer to the this is the supply power. Yeah, and the power transfer to the load when the signal is sinusoidal, the load current is on sinusoidal neglected distortion. Right? So the power transfer to the load when the signal is sinusoidal, the load current is from is on sinusoidal neglecting the distortion. What happens is that I load is equal to ICN sine omega t, and that P load is equal to I squared from 2. Because 5.2 we're using 5.22 and using 5.22, all right, let us try doing that. Let's get some space here. Using 5.22, we now have CQ over 2 log n equals z squared to log n. We call this equation 5.2 and 5.2. So we maintain the same designation so as to make reference that the equations are more simple. In general, I could have used my own numerical number for the equations, but I find it more convenient to use the same number. And so that when we're making reference to the equations for substitution, then you could refer back to the relevant numbering. So we're going to look at the collector dissipation now. So the collector. Maximum collector dissipation is with no signal present. Yeah, the maximum collector dissipation happens when there's no signal present. And the consequence of the 5.2-14A. That is PCP, preload max. The efficiency of the operation is also unchanged. And we'll also look at the figure now. So in practice, the transistors are not constructed in the simplified term as indicated in 2.1, equation 2.1, with alpha sub f approximately equal to alpha r. Typically, they are designed so that alpha f is approximately equal to 1. and alpha subbar approximately equal to 0.01. And in addition, the saturation current are related to the current gained by the relation. Specificity is alpha RDT. For typical values of alpha F and that, we see that ICO will usually be significantly larger than ICO will be significantly larger. So let's just generally look at the transformer copper core amplifier, and like we were referring back to the inductor copper amplifier in this calculation on this outing, I'll try to cover the inductor copper amplifier, in which there will be a lot of similarities in the power calculation and similarities in the diagram. Will we expect that a different diagram will come up here? It's about how you transform the 2 3 liters of the inductor. And we'll also look at the DC and AC load line, or